Special education, our assistant superintendent for special education, Ms. Tamara Walker.
Good evening, board. Good evening, community. We recently had our special education quality assurance program and services review, which is conducted by the Office of Special Education Quality Review. So we just wanted to give an overview of that. The review was conducted for the 2016-2017 school year. It began around October, and it focused around three primary schools, Summit Park, Greenview, and Fleetwood. When they also looked at sample students, it included about 40 sample students, but those were our primary focuses that were chosen by the office. As we mentioned also, as I said, that the 40 students were focused in grades 1 to 3, and that was just chosen because just out of random selection out of the Office of Special Education. The review design focused on compliance in the following areas: IEP development, IEP implementation, instruction from qualified staff, delivery of special education programs and services. behavioral interventions, what they would call timeout loop if it's applicable for our district, that's not applicable, and parental awareness of special education delivery and progress. So, as part of the review, the activities included the review of our staff, their certification, their licensure, the review of their student records, and this primarily included the students, the 2015-2016 IEPs, the IEPs that were created from the previous school year. They also visited and sat in on CSE meetings. They visited our classrooms, spoke with our teachers, there were surveys and interviews, teachers, service providers, administrators, and actually parents of students that were in the sample. So when we had our outcomes of the review, we met in August of August 11th, and the district was found to be non-compliant in 8 out of 87 reviewed areas. So non-compliance occurs when just even one, so like you said, there was a sample group of 40 students. So if one out of the 40 areas or one of the 40 IEPs was not in alignment, we would be considered non-compliant. And of all the 8 non-compliant areas, it falls under the category of IEP development, and which is inclusive of what we call prior written notices, which are the notices that are sent to parents following an IEP meeting, following a CSE meeting. So one of the things that I think is important for us to know is that this wasn't anything as the reviewer, as the reviewer mentioned to us, it's something that's very, as we would consider it, very common to occur and easy to occur. But one of the things that we should note is that the district has ongoing professional development in the particular area that we were found non-compliant in. So one of the things to note is that we, as a way of constantly addressing it and to minimize those errors from occurring, we have annual professional development for staff in regards to how to write IEPs. Even recently, we had our lawyers meet with our in November of 2016, actually at the beginning of the review, we had our lawyers come in to speak with the staff about how to appropriately write what we call PWNs, the prior written notices. We, in the summer, we do random reviews of IEPs and give teachers ongoing feedback in regards to how to better improve the writing of the IEPs. So this is an area that, you know, we are constantly working on, and we believe we can easily address
with the corrective action plan that's been put in place.
Thank you, Ms. Walker. And for the board, I just want to underscore how grateful I am that unanimously Ms. Walker was approved to be our Assistant Superintendent for Special Education, and she has done a phenomenal job. We are, as she said, focused on addressing these areas of concern, and we wanted someone from State Ed to come to make the presentation. Mr. Saberla?
Thank you, Dr. Wortham. That is something we're still working on. I'd like to have Chris Siriano, who's the head of our Office of Special Education, as well as our Assistant Commissioner Bilingual Education, talk and, you know, being able to talk from a statewide perspective and how you're doing. I think what Ms. Walker said kind of reflects what we're seeing statewide. Need for improvement, glad there's a corrective action plan. So I guess my question to Ms. Walker would be, you'd anticipate having these corrections made by the end of this school year, if not before?
Yeah, one of the reasons why I wanted to note that we were looking at the 2015-2016 IEPs is the fact that we had already begun most of the work already. So right. I'm sure most of it is already mm-hmm. corrected. Mm-hmm.
And so while we were waiting for Mr. Saberla to have someone to come and to make the presentation, what better person to make the presentation other than Tamara Walker? So thank you so very much. And Ms. Walker, again, I appreciate your expertise and your time and talent in the area of special education.